the time in the first period. And watch this save by Akira Schmidt. He's made plenty in this one, especially in the first two periods. As Hedl's able to get that puck over to Kako, it's bouncing, he chips at it, and Akira Schmidt stays focused at your Volvo, saving the game, and gets
an individual effort to buy time and space. He pulls coverage away. That opens up Mercer in the bumper position, and then he finds Hall in that front. But again, as the Devils win the faceoff, they get into their look. Beautiful patience and poise, and then he uses his backhand to find Mercer. And because of what Severson did, he pulled the whole coverage of the penalty kill way too up high. That left both Holla and Mercer wide open to make a beautiful play. Pressure here, forcing turnovers, and then beautiful pass here. Look at the patience. Feeds it right into the shooting lane. Mercer does not even have to adjust it. He can totally one-time it. Right there was a great stick check there by Holla to deflect that. Now Mercer comes out, aggressiveness. That forces a bubbled pass. Then the Devils are off to the races here. And that's what's really evident here on the penalty kill, is their assertiveness in the defensive zone. All four guys putting pressure on the Rangers to then force their plays. And if you look there, there's a lot of talk coming into this game that they're moving.
The break as the Tri-Honda second intermission report continues. We'll have a look at the stats after 40 minutes.
The pile, as that puck was sitting in the crease and then it was loose. So, well, it's going to be interesting what the calls are here, if any.
Man, it's just that kind of night if that puck doesn't go in there.
It really is. It was sitting there right around the goal line. But, I mean, Panarin wasn't even jumped in the pile and tried to jump on Schmidt.
This is one of those where they had a call penalty on both guys, even though Siegenthaler didn't do anything.
Minor penalty cross-checking. New Jersey number 71, minor penalty roughing, removing a player's helmet.
I guess maybe earlier in the shift he had brought Lindgren's helmet off, but then Lindgren came over, cross-checked him a couple of times, and both go off.
Well, understandably so, but just watch the sequence here. A quick wraparound, looks like Tarasenko might have him. That one goes off the post. Tarasenko can't poke it in as it kind of rolls along the goal line.
Well, there's Siegenthaler going to work. He earned that penalty.
Yeah, no, and Panarin, I missed, but he just kind of dove into the pile. One more look at it. Great overhead angle. They hit the pipe. It stays out. Look at the effort by Eric Holla to swing his stick to kind of disrupt Tarasenko from being able to poke it in the empty net. And then all chaos.
He even got a piece of it. Holla saved
Eric
the goal.
Holla saved it. And it also affected Tarasenko from... There's Panarin. See Panarin? He just... I'm not sure what he was doing. I mean, because he wasn't even looking for the puck.
Well, penalties on Lindgren and Siegenthaler, so we'll play 4-on-4. Eric Holla has a goal and an assist, and now you can give him a save as well as his great game continues.
He has been nothing short of outstanding.
Goal today, 4-0.
Well, he put an exclamation point on this. There's still 5 minutes left, just over, but what a perfect scenario for the Devils. And Eric Holla has the pinpoint accuracy from his own zone, and he hits the bulls actually win the draw. Zibanejad, it kind of squirts free, but Panarin can't get to it. Holla reads it, and right in the middle of the net. And that's exactly what you need, because if the Rangers score with the goalie out, you know there's a lot more pressure on the Devils, and they got a lot of guys.
A parade of blue making its way to the parking lot as the Rangers fans are leaving. The Devils fans staying put on their feet and just raucous here. Soak this in, Devils fans. You deserve it. We're able to do that. Now you got to make sure you don't get too high off a game like this. With another game just two nights from now at MSG, and you wonder how the Rangers are going to respond to a third straight loss.
Those scrums, everybody has to stick together. And if I'm the Devils, I don't think you need Jack Hughes out there anymore the rest of this game, in my opinion, though.
RWJ Barnabas Health proud to recognize he's got 23 saves from Akira Schmid, 2 goals from Eric Holla, goals from Andre Palat, and Dawson Mercer, the first of his playoff career.
Mercer. I mean, he's playing with confidence, and he's starting to understand. He's a behemoth of a man. You've got to use it.
Michael McLeod draws a penalty, sets up, ball shots deflected, and shot goes wide. Here's Damon Severson. Meyer shoots again. Save Shesterkin. There's the horn. And look out, because this Devils team now has some playoff experience and has three straight playoff wins. Devils lead the series 3-2.
They're riding the hot hand of Kara Schmidt. Been terrific the last three, but this was maybe even his best performance. I know he didn't have a ton of work there, but especially in the first period, Bill, he made some rock solid saves. And we always say the Devils goaltending doesn't have to be spectacular. Vanacek provided that all year for the Devils, but just make timely saves, big saves. Well, Schmidt's done that and then some the last three games, and the Devils one win away from winning this series.
Kara Schmidt came into Madison Square Garden with this team down 2-0 in game three, needing that win, and he has stopped 80 of the next first career playoff three-point game.